गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, वेलकम बैक टू सोशल स्टडीज ट्यूटोरियल। सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ आवर हिस्ट्री, व्हेन, वेयर एंड हाउ द मिडाइवल हिस्ट्री और द मिडाइवल पीरियड इन इंडिया। सो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स फर्स्ट टॉक अबाउट हिस्ट्री, दैट व्हाट हिस्ट्री इज। स्टूडेंट्स, हिस्ट्री is the study of past events and it is much more than memorizing dates. Indian history is divided into three periods, that is ancient history, medieval period and your modern period. So the first is ancient history, that is 4000 BC to AD 500, with and medieval period or medieval history, that was AD 500 to AD 1500, and the modern history, that is of AD 1500 to present. So the word medieval comes from the Latin words medius and aver, which means the middle age. Therefore, medieval period means that the period which is in the middle of human history. So the medieval period in India is divided into two periods, early medieval period and later medieval period. There are different dynasties that ruled in India from the 11th to the 18th centuries CE. These were Turkish, Afghan, Persian and Mongol. So students, now let's talk about the impact of geography on history. As you know that India is a vast land with a 5,422 kilometer along coastline, having diverse physical and cultural variations because of the Himalayan mountain ranges that stretch over 2,575 kilometers along the north of India, which cut off the Indian subcontinent from the rest of Asia. So, the Indian subcontinent is a term which is used to describe the area consisting of the present-day countries of India, Pakistan, Bhutan, Nepal and Bangladesh. Due to the distinct nature of India's relief features, India's history developed differently in its different regions. For example, the northern plains comprising the basins of the rivers Indus and Ganga was the seat of many empires and was also under constant threat from invaders. On the other hand, the Vindhya and Satpura mountain ranges provided safeguards to the southern peninsula. The kingdoms in the south, like the Cholas and Pandyas, developed strong navies and were able to establish their empires across the Indian Ocean, including the islands of Sri Lanka and Indonesia. There are different terms which are used to describe the subcontinent. So, if we talk about Sapt Sindhu, during Vedic age, India was known as Sapt Sindhu or the land of seven rivers. These rivers were Indus, Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bees, Satluj and the mythical Saraswati. Sindhu was the Sanskrit name used for the river Indus, and this reference was found in a holy book of ancient Persians, Zend Avesta. Then Hindustan. The word Hindu was derived from the Sanskrit word Indu, used for Soma, the drink of the Vedic people, which was first offered to the god and then consumed by the people Hindu. The land where the Hindu lived was called Hindustan. Then Aryavart, that was northern India, came to be known as Aryavarta or the land of Aryans. Then the other term which is used to describe subcontinent, that is Bharatvarsha, the land of Bharat, the son of King Dushyanta, who was a mythical king and believed to have conquered and ruled over the whole of the Indian subcontinent. Then Hind or Indica, all Arabian and Persian literature referred the Indian subcontinent as Hind, and the people living here were known as Hindus, and however, the Greeks called this land as Indica. So most probably from this term, the subcontinent got its modern name, India. Students, this was the concept of history and its classification. We have also talked about the physical features and the different terms which are used to describe the subcontinent. We'll discuss the remaining chapter in our next session. Till the time, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.